The Skydrive and Onedrive is pretty notorious for syncing data at all times and chewing through your bandwidth. So if you are like me and have a internet cable provider that gives you a data cap, and mine's at 300 gigs, but I blew through it in the first week just from the Skydrive / Onedrive. Not really sure what was going on. I probably had about 1,000 files, pictures, some different stuff in there. But it would constantly just keep trying to sync it, even though it says it's up to date. And one way to tell if this is happening to you is to go into the Task Manager, and you can look at all your services that are currently running. I'm on Windows 8.1 at the moment. I found this is, since it started happening, I think they switched over to the OneDrive. Not sure if there was something else going on here or not, but you can look on your fourth column here. It says Network. This is going to tell you what's being used on the network, what's chewing through data, if you have anything really going to town on it. I found Outlook does it a little bit. So you'll find SkyDrive in here, OneDrive. Should be OneDrive if it's updated. But I had like constantly 18, 20 megabits just running at all times. And I saw in one day 70 gigs used. And it was essentially that, because we're under 10 gigs a day now, easily, every single day. So we don't even come close now. At first we thought it was our streaming, because we don't have TV besides Netflix and stuff like that. But we found the culprit, and it was this. So I would check it here to see if it's actually running all the time. If you have a lot of stuff in there, it's probably that also. So the other thing you can do is check the OneDrive here. I had to delete everything out of it. So if you go over here to OneDrive, you'll go ahead and find it. I had a bunch of files. You'll have file folders here if you save stuff to it constantly. That's one of the areas to find it. I went through and cleared out all my deleted files. Another thing is it runs down here in this little program bar. Mine still runs, but I don't have any files in it, luckily. It says files are up to date. I don't even have any files, so it'd be nice if they fix that somehow. And I constantly just shut it off via Task Manager, even now. And we have like three or four computers, and we had three or four of them doing this at the same time, so we just got SkyDrive. We deleted all our files, now we're using Dropbox or Google Drive. They seem to be working okay. And the other thing you can do is go into your settings. So if you go to your computer settings, go to the top right corner, go down to settings, change PC settings. And then if you go to, I believe it's OneDrive right here, it'll give you some settings. Like I have 145 gigs of storage, but it's kind of pointless when it just chews through mine. So you go to metered connections. If you have a metered connection, say you're on like a mobile hotspot or use a data stick or something like that, you can turn this on so it only does it sometimes. Not when you're roaming. Sync settings, you can turn off things so it's not constantly syncing everything. I found this just to be bad on all accounts. I have them on, but I have multiple computers on 8.1, so I try to keep something synced, but you can go through if you're going to have files, and you can change all that, file storage. There's a lot of different things in here you can change. The other thing to look at is if you go to the Windows home screen, so you hit the Windows key, and that's going to take you, you can find the OneDrive right here. Yours will be somewhere in the same area. Mine currently is not anything in there, but all files are up to date. If you have a bunch in there, you can sync them. That's your list view. You can learn more, you can close it. The other thing would be to go back, and I believe if you, there's normally a way to access more settings right there, and you can turn it off. A few of the other things I read is you can go in and edit the registry on your computer and just totally get rid of OneDrive from your system. But mine seemed to work after I moved all the files out of it, so I would give that a try first. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. I hope this helps. Thanks.